A piece of equipment purchased today for $20,000 can generate the following cash flows over 4 years. At the end of year 4, the equipment can be sold for $3,500. Assuming an 8% required rate of return, we want to determine the NPV and IRR of the cash flows. Since the equipment can be sold for $3,500 in year 4, we can add the $3,500 inflow to the year 4 cash flow to give $8,000. Since the equipment purchase for $20,000 occurs today, we can add that to the table as year 0. Using formula, we can compute the NPV using this calculation. Now, using the BA2+ calculator, press the CF button. Press Second Clear Work to clear previously stored values. For CFO, input $20,000. Press the plus minus button to make it negative. Enter. And scroll down. For CO1, input $5,500. Enter. Scroll down. FO1 equals 1 tells the calculator that the CO1 value, $5,500, only occurs once in a row. Scroll down. For CO2, input $7,000. Enter. Scroll down. FO2 should also be left at 1. Scroll down. For CO3, input $8,000. Enter and scroll down. Since we have $8,000 twice in a row, we can set the frequency to 2 instead of entering it twice. Enter. And we're done entering the values. Next, press the NPV button. The interest rate or rate of return is 8%, so input 8. Enter. Scroll down, and when you see NPV, press Compute. We see that the NPV is about 3325, which is greater than 0, suggesting that the equipment should be purchased. To find the internal rate of return, press the IRR button and press Compute. The IRR is 14.79%, which is the interest rate that will make the NPV equal to 0. That is the interest rate that will make the sum of the present values of these inflows equal to $20,000. Since this IRR is higher than the required rate of return or cost of capital of 8%, the equipment should be purchased. Now, suppose the equipment was purchased for $25,000. I'm going to press the CF button and change CFO to $25,000. Make it negative. Enter. Press the NPV button. I'm going to leave I at 8 and scroll down, and then compute NPV. We see that the NPV is now negative, indicating that the equipment should not be purchased. I'm going to press IRR and press compute. The IRR is now about 5%, which is less than the required rate of return of 8%, also indicating that the equipment should not be purchased for $25,000. Using Excel or Google Sheet, we can compute the NPV using equals NPV, 8% or 0.08 for the rate. Select year 1 to 4 cash flows. Note that Excel does not include period 0 using this NPV formula. You'll have to add it yourself. Enter. And that's the NPV. For the IRR, equals IRR. Select all the cash flows including the initial outlay. Enter. And that's the IRR. If the purchase price had been $25,000, we see that the NPV is negative and the IRR is less than the cost of capital of 8%, both indicating that the equipment should not be purchased for $25,000. And that's it. Thanks for watching.